Be'ezras Hashem Yisbarach. Yoyim Shlishi LeParshas Yisro. Shnas Tov Shinayin Zayin. What day in Shvat is it? Yud Ches Shvat. Chai. Subject of the Shir, Chai. Yeshiva Tiferes Avigdor. There's an interesting parsha in the Torah, Parshas Yisro, which is named after Yisro, but it's a very interesting parsha because the parsha is the parsha of Kabbalah HaTorah. Yisro's name became memorialized in conjunction with Kabbalah HaTorah. So obviously, the first simple pshat is because Yisro was a very famous individual, a Kohen Midian, who came and was Mekabel the Torah. But the Shaychus is much deeper. Now, in the Pasuk it says, Vayishma Yisro Kohen Midian. So Rashi asks, being from Chazal, Mashmua Shoma Ubo. Now, the Gemara has a question. The Gemara discusses this question, Mashmua Shoma Ubo Vinisgayer, the Gemara says. What exactly is the point of the question? In the Oz Yashir we say, Shamu Amim Yir Gozun, the nations of the world heard, Yir Gozun, they were all riled up, Chil Ochaz Yoishve Ploshes, dread seized those Yoishve Ploshes, people who lived in the land, Oz Nivhalu Alufe Edoi, the Alufim of Edoim became confounded. But in spite of that, none of them came besides for Yisro. So the Gemara wants to know that what was it that Yisro heard that caused him to come when all the nations of the world, the entire universe, heard. And they heard the same things, and none of them came. Now, this parsha, the sugya is, this week is Check Your Hearing Week. There is the Healthy Heart Week. That was parshas, Be'eirem Boi. Heart's an important thing. And then there's the Healthy Hearing Week, where a person has to check his hearing. One of the greatest gifts that Hashem gave a human being is the ability to hear. Now, most of us have never considered what is the function of hearing and what is so important about hearing. We'll think hearing is to hear somebody communicate with you. We think hearing is to hear somebody beeping. If you're driving a car and somebody's beeping, you can't hear you, you can't hear him, it's a dangerous situation. But that's not the purpose of hearing. That's just collateral benefits, side benefits. The ikar ability of hearing is given to a person of all the senses that a person has. Chazal tell us that a hearing is the most important sense, which is the chiddush. And Chazal tell us that if somebody damages somebody else, he has to pay for that aver. The Chazal Gemara tells us that if a guy smashes a guy in the ear and he makes him deaf, he has to be noisin loy demay kuloy. He has to give him his entire value. Now the question is, why is that so important? So the answer to that question is, because obviously if demay kuloy, that means the whole person's value is pushing based on his ability to hear. Now hearing is to be mekabel direction in life. Hearing is to mekabel guidance in life. Without hearing, you cannot accomplish your goals and your roles in life. Now, most people, if you ask them, how's your hearing? They'll tell you it's very good. I basically could hear. But the emes is, sometimes the person gets a stuffed ear, gets wax in his ear. Sometimes he has a ringing in his ear. Sometimes the person has different problems. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu is letting you know you have a koyach of shmiya. And we are given messages all day long. The whole Kabbalah Satorah is based upon Nase Vinishma. Now, the word hearing, Shmia, in that light, does not mean your ear working. Being able to put earbuds in your ear and listen to music is not hearing. Hearing means being able to be mekabel something. When we say Shema Yisrael, doesn't mean listen up, O Israel. What it means is be mekabel upon yourself, Hashem Elikeinu Hashem Echad. And when a person wants to check his hearing, what he needs to ask himself is how good is his ability to be mekabel something and to hear the message and to act upon it. That's a very difficult challenge. Most people have extremely, extremely poor hearing. People don't like to be mekabel from others. People struggle with accepting orders from others. And when somebody talks to you and is giving you orders and he says, are you listening? Are you hearing me? And you say, of course I hear you. But you don't hear him at all. You know why? Because you're not planning to be mekabel one word that that person says. That's why it became a nusach. The people ask you after they tell you not to go fast or not to act silly. And you act silly, they say to you, are you deaf or something? What's the problem? That is deafness. That is called serious death. The last that you have to ask yourself this question: when is the last time that you heard something and you actually said, I hear, I'm going to try to be macabled at what I heard and to change myself? That's what's called hearing. Listening is not hearing. It's shmias oizen and the Shmias Halev. You have some people who ask the same question over and over and over and over and over. Why do people do that? You know why? Because it's indication. They never listened to you once. They never heard what you said once. Because if you heard once, you don't ask again, what do I do now? What do I do in the same situation? Let's say you tell a person, in this situation, understand this is what the message from Hashem is. And the person tomorrow comes and asks the same exact question. That person is deafer than deaf itself. Garnished. No one's home. That person has no Shemiya. So he could try Shema Yisrael. He could cry Shema Yisrael. He could say Nasa Benishma, but he has no intention of Yisroel was the Shemeya. Yisroel was that individual that heard Shamu Amim. He heard everything else the world heard. Now the world was impressed by what it heard. It got nervous. It got confounded. They became full of dread. But they couldn't act upon it. And Yisroel was somebody who acted upon it. One of the greatest purposes of Shemiya is to be a Shemeya Toichachis. You have to know that a person's entire life depends on his ability to be a Shemeya Toichachis, to learn and to constantly be a Shemeya Toichachis. People go through tremendous challenges in their life. Upheavals, good and bad, but they're not Shemeya. You ask a person, what did you learn from this episode? And the answer is, garnished. Everybody thinks that I'll figure it out or I'll wing it. Now, a Shemeya Techachas means not somebody who likes to get abused. There are on rare occasions people who like, when you give them teichachis, they actually like it. You know why? Because they have low self-esteem and it reassures them. And also there are some people that like to be shmei teichachis for another reason. You know why? People like to be victims of abuse. Believe it or not. A lot of children, a lot of students, talmidim, like to be victims of abuse. You know why? Because then they can call their tatties or their mommies and they can say, you know, the pressure, they're putting pressure on me. They're putting pressure on me. Are they telling you to stop putting on tefillin? Are they telling you to learn less? Are they telling you to do less mitzvahs? Are they telling you to fight with people, not get along with people? What, they're telling you to do less chesed? What are they telling you? They're telling you to do more chesed, be a bigger mensch, be a bigger masmid, take your learning more serious, take your davening more serious. But mommy, I can't handle that. It's too much. That's called a person who, some people are shemei techachis. They like to, you know, because they like to be victims, because then they have good excuses for their lack of growth and for their lack of good behavior. But a person has to understand that a Shemeya Techach, and then there are some people who are wonderful, have wonderful midas, and when you give them Musar, you know what they say? Thank you. I appreciate that. It's amazing. Most people are not such tzaddikim. Most people, they say, thank you, I hear, good point, I hear, very nice. Are you going to change? Oh, I hope so. But Lamaisa doesn't amount to anything, zero. Because they're not Shemeya. They're listening, but there's no Shemiyas Halev. The inyan of Shemeya Teichachis means is to listen to what somebody else says and to actually implement it right away. That's all. It's amazing. In this, the Pasuk says, in Yeshaya it says, Shimu Usachi Nafshechem. Hearing will give you chai. It says Shemeya Teichachos Koine Leiv. Want to koine a healthy heart? Be a Shemeya Teichachos. Want to build yourself? Have to be a Shemeya Teichachos. The person should ask himself, when's the last time you heard Teichacha? When's the last time you listened to Teichacha and actually made a change in yourself? Somebody ask, everybody should ask himself that question. I know many times people get a patch from Hashem, then they're Shemei. I see people get into car accidents and all of a sudden they're Shemei, Shemei. It's like, maybe I wasn't right. I'll Shemei a little bit. Does it make them change? No. They don't change anything. Tomorrow they buy another car, smash another car up. That makes a difference. But they're not Shemei. Shemei means I hear something and I learn my lesson. Just today I was dealing with a fellow, or a year ago, who was driving in a rural place. And Hashem arranged it that this fellow should be one of the fourth worst places to get caught doing the fouling. He was driving a little erratically in a very small town. And a cop stopped him. And he said, can I check the car? He said, yeah, check my car. And he found the bottle of medication. And pills. So the cop said, well, what is this about? He said, I take these pills. So he said, are you a drug trafficker? He said, no. He said, these pills are the kind of pills that people traffic in drugs. Next thing, the guy was arrested, thrown into jail, charged with crazy driving, charged with having drugs in his car, called it's a vehicle, one thing doing your house, a vehicle crime, and then for trafficking, whatchamacallit. Took him a few months to wake up, and he finally started to hear, it's not a double push it. So, they contacted me. I was in Eretz Yisrael last summer. His wife contacted me, and I told him, are you ready to listen? You ready to hear? She said, what does that mean? I say, are you ready to make life changes? I said, you know, what's the chances of you getting stopped? In New York, the cop would take it, I have a couple pills myself, and I'll let you go. I said, you didn't have heroin with you. You had a regular pill. Doctors give out to patients. No big deal. So maybe he had more than five pills, but he was traveling, so he had it with him, and he was taking it. He used to use it for to relax. And then the guy changed his whole entire life. He changed his life. His wife changed her life. It was Shemaya. And I told him, you're very smart. We're very wise people. Most people don't change. They change a lot of areas of fellow. Got learning, got off those stupid pills, and he became a good father. Started visiting the shul very often. He started learning Torah, kind of get closer to Hashem. Wonderful thing. Just today, he called me up. He's not off the hook yet. He may have to go to prison, so blah, blah, blah. But that was the craziest thing, man. Craziest thing. But this is a whole lunchtime with him. This people think that doesn't happen to anybody. It happens. People have to realize. But Shemaya Techocha is a very important thing. Shemaya Techocha is kind of late. Yisro, there's a Gemara, has a machlokes. When did Yisro come? Did Yisro come before Matan Torah? Or did Yisro come after Matan Torah? So the Ramban poses a question at the beginning of the Parsha. This is according to the Man D'Amar that says Yisro came after Matan Torah. So why does the Torah write the Parsha of Yisro's coming before Matan Torah? But Rabbi Rucham says, you know what the Teretz is? Very poshut it says. Because it's telling you a prerequisite of Torah, a prerequisite of Aliyah is to be a Shemaya Techachis. You have to be someone who's acquired and developed his sense of hearing that he could change and is going to make changes based on his ability to hear. Now, you have to listen to the story because the story is immensely amazing. Here's a stranger. The guy was a pope. Moshe Rabbeinu came from Amram. He was a descendant from Yankov Avinu, Avram Yitzchak Yankov. But he was a shver. But he was a goyish shver. He was a shekets. And he was a good, a grub of a deserving. So now he comes, some stranger shows up, and he starts to give his son a lomusr. Give his son a lomusr. Immediately. He didn't wait like a few months to get acclimated. He saw right away the territory. As soon as he came, he checked out the matziv, and right away he said, Loi tevadam. It's not good what you're doing. It's not good. He didn't say, can I make a suggestion? He did say, amazingly, he said, I'm telling you what you're doing is no good, but check it out with Hashem, he says. That's what he says. Lo toiv hadavar asher ata oise, but go ask Hashem if my suggestion is right. And who is he being musr? He's giving musr to Moshe Rabbeinu, against Klal Yisrael. Unbelievable. The people just experienced Ras Hashiv Chaliyam, what Cheska Mabuzi didn't see. They're very elevated people. Especially if they have to Matan Torah, they already saw after Esau Dask, Hashem Elokim Enu Mabadah. And he's still telling him this musr. And he's pushing, what is he telling him? What kind of musr is he giving him? He's telling Moshe Rabbeinu that you are mezalzel v'kvoidon shal Yisro. That's what he says. Madua yoshev levadecha v'chol ha'am nitzav alecha min ha'boikir v'ad ha'arif. How do you understand those abikaris? I'm Moshe Rabbeinu. Yet, what does the Torah tell us? Vayishma Moshe l'kol chosnei. Not he listened, he heard. And you know what he did? Vayas kol asher amale. He did everything that he told him. Amazing. Moshe Rabbeinu has such a nevus. That's unbelievable. You should tell him that very nicely, thank you, but you keep your, how you run your Pope in Midian, you'll do your way. And here we run up with Torah. It's Das Torah. No. Now there's a very interesting thing. Moshe Rabbeinu in Chumash Devarim gave Musar to Klal Yisrael. You know why? Because when Yisro said this to Klal Yisro, what did the Yidden say? What was the Yidden's response? They said, Toiv hadavar asher dibar talasis. That's a good idea. Moshe, you should do that. Follow Yishver's advice. And Moshe Rabbeinu gave him Musar. He said, Chutzof in the best. He said, that's your answer? That's not your answer. You should have said, Moshe Rabbeinu, we can hear a psak din, or we makabel the Torah directly from Moshe Rabbeinu, or we can hear it from one of the Dayanim, which are Talmidim of Moshe Rabbeinu. We don't want to hear it from the Talmud. We want to hear it from Moshe Rabbeinu himself. Moshe Rabbeinu pushed him, was upset at that. But Afal Pike, he said, my job, Moshe Rabbeinu said, is to makabel the Teichach. You gave me techocha, mekabel techocha. But you, Klal Yisrael, you're not supposed to say, that's good musr, that's a good idea. You're supposed to say no. And you should be sure Moshe Rabbeinu thought about it. It wasn't just Amazon. Moshe Rabbeinu understood he could have Talmidim, the Shtalavek. But he understood this was the Isis Cheshbon. And he understood that no. What I'm going to do is I'm going to ask Hashem, and Hashem said a good advice. Not only that, he even added his own chidushim to that idea. In Devin Ezra, it says that when it says Vayishma l'koil chosnei, it says doesn't mention what Yisro said to do. It says Vayishma l'koil chosnei. Doesn't say Vayishma l'divre Yisro. You know why he says? Because Moshe Rabbeinu was Moisif on the Eitza of Yisro, and he was the one who placed Shaitrim, police officers, over the Shvatim to make sure they carry out the judgments of the Shaitrim. It says, Shaitreichem lishivteichem. That's the Pshat, Moshe Rabbeinu. And a person has to know that I have to be Mekabel. It's the hardest thing today. It always was a hard thing, but this is, it says, Oizen Shemas. Teichachas chayim bekeren bekerev chachamim tolim. This is going to be one of the most important hakdomas to any growth. When you see people who don't have rabbeim, what they're afraid is they're going to have to answer teichach. And today it's a door that loves to be shayfet as shaytan. The Talmud thinks that his job is to judge his rebbeim, and the Talmud thinks that in that way, I'm not sure what Talmud wants to gain by that, just another excuse why a person doesn't have to be makabel something. He can do what he wants. And a person has to understand that this is the key to success. So the avoida that a person has to do, when you have a child that gets earaches, and you want to know, what are you supposed to think? Is a person that has his own earache, adult has an earache, or some disturbance in the ear, he has to ask himself, is there something about my ear, my hearing, that I'm not listening? Is there something that I'm supposed to be doing, that I heard that I'm supposed to be doing, and for whatever reason, I'm choosing not to be mekabelit? That's what a person has to understand. And I tell people that's the reason why parents have to deal with children's earaches. Earaches is one of the most common maladies that parents deal with children. Have to run to the doctor, back and forth. They're very metapa a lot with these earaches. Because Hashem is telling the parents, think how you use your ears. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu, from a very young age, trains people to understand how important the concept of hearing is. Tendo for the Maisa, there was once a fellow here who was engaged to a young lady, and this young lady decided she wanted to come for Shabbos. I said, wonderful, love to have your Shabbos. But she chose a Shabbos, and she called me up and said, that's not a good Shabbos. There's another Talmud is having an Ufrav that Shabbos. It's going to be his Ufrav. And we're not going to be able to give you the proper attention that you and your chassan need. And she said, I want to come anyway. I said, I'm telling you, it's not a good Shabbos. He is going to be the focus of attention. Come another week. No, I want to come anyway. I said, I don't think it's a, I told you, it's not a good idea. Anyway, next thing I know, the chassan tells me she's coming. I said, boy, that's some kala. But she's not going to come to you. She's coming to the community, to see the community. Okay. So she stayed in the basement of where Rabbi Yosef Heinemann's house is now, which is now Shalom's house. Paul Parvin, that's where she stayed. Another person just lived there. So the guy told me Friday she arrived. I said, okay, good, Baruch Haba. I said, what should I do? Friday night, I don't see the guy by davening. Shabbos morning, I don't see my davening. Getting a little nervous. So I don't remember if I went myself or I sent somebody over to the house to knock on the door and to find out if anybody's downstairs. Because, you know, I'm davening, come down, I didn't see the guy, Machbuchal. Thought maybe they eloped or something on Shabbos, but it was funny. The kids, sir, I knocked on the door upstairs, and they told me no. We didn't see anybody downstairs. She arrived there for Shabbos, we didn't see her since. Moshe Shabbos, I get a call. Guy calls me from the hospital. The hospital call there. I said, what are you doing? What are you calling from the hospital for? He said, I've been in the hospital the entire Shabbos. I said, you kidding? It was before the Bikur Chalim days. I said, what were you doing there? He said, right before Kabbalah Shabbos, my Kala's eardrum burst. And we had to run emergency to the hospital. We got stuck in the whole Shabbos. When he came back, I said to him, did you ever consider, like, maybe it was a shtickle, if you're not listening? He said, yeah, we thought about it. We talked a lot over Shabbos, and we decided we're breaking up. That wasn't the thing. Maybe it was Makav Patish, but I told him it's indication of a lot more than just not. And then her brother called me up. Her brother called me up and he said, I want to tell you that I was struggling about calling you to tell her that she should break it up. That's not a good shidduch. I know my sister well. But I don't want to say anything. But tell the chassan he shouldn't feel bad at all that the shidduch dissolved. Hashem spared him. But Nebuchadnezzar's chassan didn't have good mazel. It wasn't his. For him, I saw another ashgacha. And if Hashem has in mind for you to have tzaras from your wedding, if in marriage, even if somebody wants you, this girl's dangerous. You get married to somebody else. If it's your destiny, you can't run. You can't run about it. His first wife turned out to be, everything looked fine, but she became mentally not well, and then she threw him out. That was the nicest tzaddik in the world. That's not the guy, nice guy. What a tough life they had. Anyway, it happened to him a third time also, the guy had. And he moved to Yisro. Then he runs a maisid. I met him at an airport a little while ago. But I call upon him, person has to realize Shmi Yisayzin is the key. When Hashem talks to you, listen, make changes. Make decisions based on your life. You know, many people think that if they heard about Shabbos, fry people. You tell them about Shabbos, tell them about mitzvahs, and they don't listen, it's fine. It's not so. Rabbi Yashiv Paskin, we called up, we had a shayla here, that there was somebody whose father passed away, and the father was not frum. And I told him, I'm not sure you have to sit shiva for him. So I went to ask a local Rav. He said, of course you sit shiva. So we contacted Rabbi Yashiv, one of his right-hand men. And he got back to us. He said, where did he live? He said, Eretz Yisrael. How long? No shiva. I said, he grew up, no shaykhs, he was tinnik shenishba. He said, he lived in Eretz Yisrael. Heard about Shabbos. He chose not to listen. He's not a Tiferes Yeshiva. People don't realize that. Everybody likes to say, if my grandmother, my Bubby, didn't tell me about it when I was little, so then I'm a Tiferes Yeshiva. That's not a Tiferes Yeshiva. If you hear about something and you have ability to pursue it and to study it, there's no rational mind that says you have a heter and you're putter min hamitzvahs. Because when you were six, no one told you about it. You have to understand that HaKadosh Baruch Hu sent you that message later on in life. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is talking to you. And you should get that message and grow from it. Mm-hmm.